On this longest night of the year, near the end of the season of Advent, a season of yearning and hope, anticipating Christmas. So many of us find ourselves confronting loss and griefs of all sorts, the first, or perhaps the fifth, or even the 50th. Christmas without a spouse, or a child, or a sibling, or a friend. Retired and no longer invited to office parties. Moved in, but not settled in. We find ourselves confronted by grief and metaphoric as well as literal long nights. It can feel like our whole society is Christmas mad, insisting we fit into a joyous pattern. Well, that's not where we ourselves are at. I hope this longest night service is a time and place where all of us are given a spiritual space to grieve and to be as we are. Please rise as able and open the Bible. Almighty God, grant us a quiet night and peace at the last.
Amen. Amen.
By day, O God, you grant your steadfast love, and at night your song is with me,
a prayer to the God of my life.
O Lord, support us all the day long of this troubled life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
come this night to our Advent wreath, not forgetting hope, peace, joy, and love, but recognizing that there are times when we can only anticipate them, only yearn for them. We light these four candles in honor of our loved ones and to name our losses. We who despair light this first candle, may we be held by hope. There are so many ways we try to hide our hurt and ignore that empty space in our life. A conspiracy of silence, denial, avoidance, overwork, substance abuse.
Help us, dear Lord.
We who are in distress light this second candle, may we find peace. It hurts so much. We are like a lonely city. It tastes like bitter gravel. All that is sacred, it is a desolate.
Help us, dear Lord.
We who are filled with sorrow light this third candle. May joy seep in. We tumble and twist, hands outstretched like we're on a balance beam, the edge of a cliff, enduring an earthquake.
Help us, dear Lord.
We who grapple with loss light this fourth candle. May we be uplifted by love. We remember those we love, all those blessed moments with them. Remember, too, those that were mundane and even painful. At this time, let us name aloud or in silence those people who we love and all that we have lost.
Michael, Jess,
all of it we bring before you.
Help us, dear Lord.
Thank you.
reading from Lamentations. How lonely sits the city that was once full of people. How like a widow she has become, that she was great among the nations. She that was a princess among the provinces has become a vassal. She weeps bitterly in the night with tears on her cheeks. Among all her lovers, she has no one to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They have become her enemies. Judah has gone into exile with suffering and hard servitude. She lives now among the nations and finds no resting place. Her pursuers have all overtaken her in the midst of her distress. The roads to Zion mourn, for no one comes to the festivals. All her gates are desolate. Her priests groan. Her young girls grieve. And her lot is bitter. Another reading from Romans. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words.
In many and various ways, God spoke to his people of old by the prophets. But now, in these last days,
he has spoken to us by his Son.
Thank you.
Please be seated. A reading from John. When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been there, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. The Gospel of our Lord. Grace, peace, and mercy to you in the name of Jesus Christ, who is our Lord, our Savior, and our friend. Amen. Jesus wept is a Christmas verse, a central message of the Christmas story. Now, you might have been slightly confused which Mary we are talking about, because in this season of Christmas where we're focused on Mary, the mother of God, right? Jesus' mother. But today, these verses, while they are placed at the moment of Mary and Martha, Lazarus' brother, at their moment of grief for Lazarus who has died, this moment before the first of those miracles where Lazarus is called out of the tomb, right? That's what's about to happen. But there's already a miracle before the actual miracle. Jesus wept. Jesus wept. He wasn't there for the sisters in their mourning. Jesus wept. He is late to the public period of mourning. Jesus wept outside Lazarus's tomb. Jesus wept. It's about Jesus being there, even in his absence, even when late, even face to face with death. Jesus present in disappointment, sorrow, and the grave. Jesus wept. It is also a Christmas story, right? It's the story of a baby weeping in a manger, experiencing the chill air outside the womb and wailing in response, having left that nice warm home of moments before. And that puts flesh on the doctrinal statement of the church, right? That Jesus is fully human. It takes on a fleshy poignancy there at the manger. God enters into the world, this beautiful, awful world, fitting into our space. God fits into our space, enters in and wails along with us. The Christmas story is about God's presence and solidarity with humanity, all of us. It is an ongoing reminder that we are not alone. You are not alone. Not alone in your tears, your fears, your worries, your losses. God enters into all of them because Jesus wept. Let us pray. Lord God, may the words of my mouth in the meditations of all of our hearts, be acceptable in your sight. Lord God, may the preacher decrease, that you might increase. Amen. Do you all know what tears do? Firstly, they lubricate our eyes and they remove grit. They also remove various stress chemicals. But, and this is the important thing for tonight, weeping is a social signal of empathy. Empathy. Having compassion for, suffering with. Tears tell us that the other person is suffering with us. So when we hear those words, Jesus wept, it signifies to us that God has empathy for us. God is compassionate, suffers with. God suffers with us. Yes, the baby who wept at the manger was the man who wept with Mary and with Martha over their brother Lazarus. But not only that. At the desolation of Jerusalem written of in Lamentations, a beloved city experiencing all these things that people who are mourning, people who are suffering experience, widowhood, abandonment, exile, all of these things there, Jesus weeps. With the psalmist in the darkest valley and before the most frightening of enemies, Jesus weeps. At the world groaning, joining us with sighs too deep for words, Jesus weeps. Jesus wept. That is, if we put a point on it, what makes Christmas so hard? So hard for those who have tender hearts and hearts that have been tenderized by the weight of the world. God born among us means among us as we are. Right, as we actually are, not as the world might want us to be. As we live and as we die. Now that does not make for a good Christmas special. It does not fit well on a Christmas card. That doesn't feel like the stereotypical reason for the season. But it is. It is. Jesus wept. Jesus wept with and for a young local poet I know who took his life this year. Jesus wept with folk who've lost their job, folk suffering with hunger. Jesus wept alongside people abusing substances and those struggling to escape addiction. Jesus wept with people in physical and mental decline. Jesus wept standing between abuser and survivor. Jesus wept in the midst of changed lives. Now this is kind of the funny one, right? So even good changes, right, even things that are positive in your life that are different than that they used to be, even those cause funny and strange reactions in us. Right, that's the weird thing about being embodied human beings. Even good changes cause us to experience grief. That's why I'm so glad that God is embodied and experiences those tears as well. Because that means God can fully be with us in our griefs, even those that seem to us irrational or embarrassing or even just plain goofy. Jesus wept with us, rather weeps with us, in the darkest and the longest of nights. In fact, this particular night, for a not insignificant subset of human beings, is an experience of a sort of collective sundown. Right? If you've ever been in a nursing home at night, there's this point where it becomes just dark enough that some of the people there just go a little funny. And so too, the dark nights of winter in the northern hemisphere does the same thing to us collectively. We sundown this time of year. In fact, cultures around the world respond with blowout festivals and lights galore to keep back the night. Right? I mean, this is a thing that you can see in the way human beings celebrate. Jesus wept at every disappointment in all the comparisons we make with other people, because we've not yet internalized the truth that comparison can be a type of self-injury. Jesus wept while holding our isolation, our uncomfortable memories, our overscheduled lives, our excessive expectations. Jesus wept, cries, compassion, suffering with, empathy, God in the flesh crying as a baby, as well as with Mary and Martha as they mourn. Jesus wept, a child born in this world of ours, a child that weeps, a world that groans, a world whose groans are labor pains like Mary's, birthing a new world with us. Jesus wept, weeps with us, right here and right now. Candles lit in the night, community gathered, lifting up names, naming experiences, holding out hope. With us, in the complexity of our grief, out of our unsaid or weakly spoken words, hidden in the small things we often miss or disregard as unimportant, in our impulses to reach out and as kindness to one another. Jesus wept is a Christmas message. It takes seriously that God comes to dwell with us. Take seriously, too, all our experiences of this world. I pray that God meets us in this long night.
Thank you.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night. And give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, comfort the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake.
Amen.
And let us pray as Jesus taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory,
forever and ever. Amen.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Amen.